Hey everyone.
Welcome to the second episode of
Shredder Tales. I am Nimauno.
I am Anik.
I am Ombika, and today we will be discussing
the first jewel of the holy trinity of photography, aperture.
Without further ado, let's get started. Now this episode is going to be a bit different. As we know, we are currently facing a global crisis of COVID-19 outbreak. So to promote social distancing, we are bringing you this episode right from our respective homes instead of our beloved campus.
On this note, we also want to remind you all to also to wash your hands and take all preventive measures recommended by the WHO to prevent the spread of the virus. Remember, we all are in this together and we shall get over this.
Now we realize you're probably tired of hearing this, but social distancing is imperative. We know, sitting at home sucks. So while you're at it, maybe learn something and see if it breaks the boredom down.
Which brings us to the topic of aperture. Now, aperture can be defined as a hole or an opening in the lens through which the light travels. Biologically speaking, it corresponds to the pupil of our eyes. Just as the pupil controls the amount of light falling on the retina, the aperture controls the amount of light falling on the image sensor of the camera.
Now to express the aperture, we used F numbers. The higher number like F22 means the smaller aperture, and the lower number like F1.8 means the large aperture.
So to realize how it looks, let's have a look at a lens. This is what a small aperture looks like. The small opening limits the light entering the lens and reaching the camera sensor. This is useful for bright scenes with a lot of light. On the other hand, this is what a large aperture looks like. The opening is wide enough to allow large amounts of light to enter. This is useful for low light scenarios.
Now, apart from controlling the amount of light entering, the aperture also controls another important feature of a photo, that is, the depth of field. The depth of field is essentially how much the background is diffused with respect to the object in focus.
So to see how it works, let's take a photo of this object using two different aperture settings. For the first one, we set a large aperture, like f1.8, and take the photo. We get this result. Now for the second one, we set a small aperture, like f22, and take the photo. We get this. So you can clearly see the difference in the two results. A large aperture gives a shallow depth of field, and thus the background is more blurred.
Once you get hang of it, you will be creative with it. A wide aperture is used when you want to focus more on the subject and set it apart from the background. It is also frequently used to create an effect called bokeh, and which is essentially blurring out point light sources to form diffused circles.
On the other hand, a small aperture is needed in landscape shots, where we need a wider depth of field so that the more of the scenery is in focus. This can be used to create an effect called starburst, where the point sources are diffracted by the aperture blades to make it appear like a star.
So that is the basic concept of aperture. We hope you enjoyed the video, got something out of it. If you have any questions, hop in the comment section below. And do like, share and subscribe to our channel. And we will see you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay awesome, and as always, get creative.